हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज सविता पवार। वेलकम टू माय चैनल गेट द मैथ। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू सी द सॉल्यूशंस ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 2.5 फ्रॉम क्वेश्चन 1 to 7 ऑफ लेसन 2 पॉलीनोमियल्स। फ्रॉम योर अर्लियर क्लासेस लेट अस रिकॉल दैट एन अल्जेब्रिक आइडेंटिटी इज एन अल्जेब्रिक इक्वेशन दैट इज ट्रू फॉर ऑल द वैल्यूज ऑफ वेरिएबल्स ऑकरिंग इन इट। And some of the algebraic identities that you have studied in your earlier classes, these are x plus y the whole square equal to x square plus 2xy plus y square. Second identity is x minus y the whole square equal to x square minus 2xy plus y square. Third identity is x square minus y square equal to x plus y and x minus y. And fourth is x plus a and x plus b, that is the first term is the same, then the expansion is x square plus a plus b. The second term you have to add, multiply it with the first term a plus b into x plus multiply the both the second terms, that is a into b. So these are the four identities you have studied till now, and we have used these identities to factorize the algebraic expressions. Now in 9th standard these four more identities you are going to study, that is identity 5th, 6th, 7th and 8th. Now we will see it earlier as the question we will start to solve. Okay, so this is the 5th identity, that is x plus y the whole square is, its expansion you have to write, that is x square plus y square plus z square plus 2xy plus 2yz plus 2zx. This is whole cube, a plus b whole cube, or x plus y the whole cube is x cube plus y cube plus 3xy plus multiply by x plus y. And if it is minus here, you have to write minus everywhere. That is x cube minus y cube minus 3xy bracket x minus y. This is multiplication here. Okay, no need to remember this. It is, if you open the bracket, you get this answer. And this is cube of each term, x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz is equal to x plus y plus z multiply by x square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz and minus zx. So these are the 5, 6, 7, 8, these are the four identities that we are going to study in your class 9th standard for lesson number 2 in exercise 2.5. let us start with exercise. Here they have written use suitable identities to find the following products. Now looking at the question, you must remember which identity we will be using it here to solve the given expression. So this is of the form a plus x plus a and x plus b. The first term is the same here, second terms are different. So this identity you have to use, it becomes, its expansion is x square plus a plus bx plus ab. Now apply that expression here. So this is x square plus 4 plus 10 into x plus 4 into 10, and 4 plus 10 is 14x and 4 tens is 40. So this is the required expression. Let us solve for this one here. So it will be x square plus 8 minus 10, write its sign too, and x plus 8 into minus 10. Okay, so it is x square plus minus is minus, so it is minus 2x, and 10 is a 80, so it is minus 80. This is the required expression. In this case here, this is 3x the whole square plus 4 minus 5 into 3x plus 4 into minus 5. So it will be 9x square. 4 minus 5 is minus 1 and plus minus is minus 1 3 is 3x and 5 4 is 20 plus minus is minus 20. So this way you have to see the sign also and accordingly write the answer. Now fourth part of the first question here, this is of the form a plus b and a minus b. See the terms are the same but the symbols are different here, plus and minus, so you have to use this identity here. So it will be, its expansion is given, you have to write the quotient here, so it will be x square minus y square. So it will be first term square minus second term square. It becomes y raised to 4 minus 9 upon 4. Let us see this one here. This is also first term is the same, second term is also same. Only plus and minus is different. So it is of this form. So you have to write x square, that is 3 square, first term square minus second term square is 2x square. So it will be 9 minus 4x square. That is the expansion. Question 2 is about evaluate the following products without multiplying directly. So here you should not, these are the numbers, so you do not have to multiply, but you have to use the identity and solve it. So this 103 can be written as 100 plus 3, 107 can be written as 100 plus 7. Now you can see first term is the same here, so apply this identity here. So it will be 100 square plus 3 plus 7 multiplied by 100 plus 3 into 7. 100 square is 10,000 plus 7 plus 3 is 10 into 100 is 1000 plus 21. So that will give you, after adding all these things, you will get the answer as 11021. So this is the answer. For this one, it is 95 into 96. So 90 plus 5 and 90 plus 6. Now this will be first term square is 90 square plus 5 plus 6 into 90 multiplied by 5 into 6. That will give you 8100. 5 plus 6 is 11. 11 into 9 is 990 multiplied by 5, 6 is 30. Not multiply, add. This is plus here. Plus 5, 6 is 30. Now on adding all this, you will get it as 9120 is the answer. Okay. Now in this case here, this is 104 and 96. One is bigger number, one is smaller number. So you get 104 by adding 100 plus 4 and you get 96 by subtracting 100 minus 4. So this becomes of the form a square minus b square. So it will be 100 square minus 4 square. 100 square is 10,000. 4 square is 16. So 100 minus 16 is 9984. So this will be 9984 is your required answer. So this way, by using the identity, you have to solve these questions. Question 3, the identity that we are going to use here is x plus y the whole square equal to x square plus 2xy plus y square. And if it is minus here, so you have to write the minus for the middle term only. So it becomes x minus y the whole square equal to x square minus 2xy plus y square. So if it is plus here, write plus for the middle term. There will be plus for both the equations, and if it is minus here, then you have to change the middle term to minus. So this first question here, 9x square plus 6xy plus y square, it becomes, write the root first of the first term, 3x square. 9x square means 3x square, and split the middle term, that is 2xy. So 2 into first term into last term. So last term is y square, so its root is y. And therefore, the equation becomes first and the last term, right? And write the symbol of the middle term, that is plus. So this way you have to solve your equation. You have been given the expansion here, you have to write the question here. So this is the question for this expansion. That is 3x plus y the whole square. Let us see for this one here. This becomes 4y square, means write its root. So it is 2y the whole square. Minus sign is there, then write the root of the last term first and write the middle term afterwards. That is 2 into first term into last term. Okay, and write the first term, last term and the symbol sign of the middle term and whole square. So this way you have to write the answer. This is of the form x square minus y square upon 100. So this is a square minus b square or x square minus y square. So its expansion is this one. Okay. okay? So it is x plus y by 100, first bracket, and x minus y by 100 is the second bracket. This is the answer. That's it. Fourth question here is, expand each of the following using the suitable identities. Now these are the new identities that we are going to study. So x plus y plus z, three terms and its whole square is x square plus y square plus z square plus 2xy plus 2yz plus 2zx. So this is first question given as x plus 2y plus 4z. We will use this identity here to solve this question. So first term is x square plus second term square plus third term square plus 2 into first term into second term plus 2 into second term into third term and plus 2 into third term into first term. Okay, so your answer will be, this will be x square plus 4y square plus 4 square is 16z square and multiply this, 2 2za is 4xy. This will be 4 4za 16yz and this is 4 2za is 8xz. This is the expansion of this question. Similarly here, now if it is minus here, put the plus sign outside and take minus sign for the term. It will be easy for you to write the equation. Okay. So this is 2x square plus minus y square plus z square plus 2 into first into second term plus 2 into second into third term plus 2 into third into first term. And then multiply and write the square. So this is your required expansion. Similarly for this question here, minus 2x square plus 3y square plus 2z square plus 2 into first into second plus 2 into second into third term plus 2 into third into first term and write the squares of the first three terms and multiply these numbers and you get this expansion for the particular question. Let us see this third one here. So this will be 3a square plus minus 7b square plus minus c square plus, we have written the square of each of the terms, then multiply with 2 into first term into second term along with the sign plus 2 into second term into third term plus 2 into third term multiply by first term. So you get here as 3 square is 9a square, 7 square is 49, minus minus become plus, c square, plus minus is minus, 2 3s are 6, 6 7s is 42ab, this is minus minus plus and plus plus is plus here, 7 2s is 14bc. And this will be plus minus is minus, 3 2s is 6ac. So this is the required expansion for this question. Similarly, you can write for this also. Same thing. And for this question now, 1 upon 4a minus 1 upon 2b plus 1 the whole square. First term, second term and third term square. We will write the minus sign with the term and write plus only here. Then plus 2 into first term into second plus 2 into second into third plus 2 into third into first term. And write the squares of the numbers and multiply these two inside. So these two will get cancelled with these two. So it will remain plus minus is minus AB upon 4. These two will get cancelled with this. So it will be minus B. Okay. And 2 1s are 2, 2s are 4. So it will be A by 2. Like that. Question fifth here is, The identity that we are going to use in this question is x plus y plus z the whole square equal to x square plus y square plus z square plus 2xy plus 2yz and plus 2xz. The same one that we have used in question 4. Now here the expansion has been given. You have to write this question here. So to write the question, you have to write the roots now. You have to go inverse now. So it will be 2x the whole square plus 3y the whole square plus 16 means 4z the whole square plus 2 multiply by, okay. So here it is 12xy. We know first and the second term you have to write, that is 2x into 3y. See, on multiplying you are getting 12xy. 4 3 is 12xy. Okay. Then plus, here it is 2 into, the second will be second and third one, 3y into 4z. Now since it is minus here, so you have to see minus term for these two, minus is there. So which variable is common in both these things? So it is z is common. So z will be minus. Okay. So z will be minus here. So you have to write z here minus. Then plus 2 into third term is minus 4z and first term is 2x. Okay. So its expansion we have written here. Now you have to write this question. So the terms will be for that question is 2x, 3y and 4z the whole square. Now what are the signs in between this? So this x is plus, x and y are plus both, and y is z is minus here. So this way you have to put the signs in between these terms. How we can see? We have to see which variable is common when it is minus given. So that variable you have to put it minus. Similarly, this question, it is 2x square plus y square plus 8z square minus 2 root 2xy plus 4 root 2yz minus 8xz. So 2 root is root 2x the whole square plus y square, and 8 means 2 root 2, that is 2 to the 4, if you, it goes inside, it becomes 8 here. So it is 2 root 2 and z square. Then 2 into first term into second term. Now since see here, my negative sign is here and in this question it is here. So in both these terms, x is common. So you have to put negative sign to x. Okay. So you have to put negative to x here. Minus. Okay. So this is 2 into first term into second term, 2 into second into third term, and 2 into first into last term, third term. And then you have to write the terms here all, first, second and third, and put the minus sign here, that is square. Question 6 is, write the cubes of the following. So this is a plus b the whole square, or x plus y the whole cube is x cube plus y cube plus 3xy plus x plus y. This is the formula. And x minus y the whole cube is, if it is minus here, all the terms are negative. If it is plus here, all the terms are positive. So it is x cube minus y cube minus 3xy and x minus y. So we will be using these two identities here. So this one is of plus. So use this one here. Simply write the values in the place of the variables and write its cubes and multiply this one. So we will see for the negative one. First term cube plus second term cube. Okay. Or simply you can write minus also in both the things. Minus 3b cube minus 3 into 2a into 3b. And the bracket, that is same as the question, 2a minus 3b. So it will be 8a cube, 27b cube, minus 3 to the 6. 6 3 is 18ab, 2a minus 3b. So this will be your, now multiply 18 inside the bracket. So these are like as it is 8a cube minus 27b cube minus 18 2a is 36 a square b a square b minus minus will become plus here and 18 3a 54 a b square. Okay, so this way you have to solve this question number 2. Similarly, this one now here, question number 3. First term cube, so 3 by 2 x the whole cube. Now since it is plus, so all the terms will be plus. First cube plus 3 into first term into second term and the bracket of the question as it is. So this is 27 x cube upon 8 plus 1 plus 9x upon 2 and 3x upon 2 plus 1. Now multiply this 9x inside. So it will be 27x cube upon 8 plus 1 plus 9 3 is 27x square upon 4 plus 9x upon 2. This is the answer. And same for this question you have to do. So this is x cube minus 2 upon 3 y cube minus 3 into first into second term and the question as it is. Write its cube and multiply this. This 3, 3 will get cancelled here. So it will remain 2xy. Now multiply this 2xy inside the bracket. You will get as 2x square y and minus minus will become plus. 2 2 is 4xy square upon 3. The seventh question here is same identity you have to use. Now it is given numbers. 99 cube means 100 minus 1 cube. So 100 cube minus 1 cube minus 3 into 100 into 1 and the question. So if you solve this one you will get it as 970299. 100 cube is write 3 times 0. So 00. This is 1, this is 300, 100 minus 1, multiply 300 inside the bracket. Now, add and subtract these terms, you get this answer. We'll see for this one here. So, this is 100 cube plus 2 cube plus 3 into 100 into 2. And the question as it is, that is 100 plus 2. So 100 cube means 3 times 100. You get 6 zeros. 2 cube is 8. 3 2s are 600. And 100 plus 2. So this is 10 lakh. 8. 6 into 100 is 60,000. And 6 into 2 is 1200. After adding all these things, you will get the answer as 1061208. This is the answer. Now similarly for 998 cube is 1000 minus 2, the whole cube. So first term cube, second term cube, and 3 into first into second term and the question itself. Okay, and since it is minus here, so minus everywhere, and write the cubes of these numbers and solve it, you get this answer 9940 11992. So it's a, since this is a very lengthy exercise, so I'll making the video of question 8 to 16, another video for this. So that's all for now. If you have any query, drop it in the comment box. Do like, share and subscribe my channel. Get the math.